It's time for Commonwealth Common Sense with Susan Stimpson and Kevin Shola.
Hey, Susan, welcome back.
Thank you, Kevin. It's nice to be here.
So you want to talk today about an approach from politicians that you've noticed. We've talked about a lot of the corruption in D.C. and a lot of the cronyism and extortion, as Peter Schweitzer puts it in his new book. But you've noticed even on local levels, some people not playing fair, shall we say.
Yes, I would agree. And it's not just at the local level, but I'm watching what's happening in Virginia, and it's something that is happening nationwide that we saw President Obama do. It's a strategy that the Democrats have that's working quite effectively for them. I happened to be watching TV last night around 7:30 p.m., and the commercials that play are just brutal on the attacks Republicans on women and making them think that if you vote for a Republican, every single choice that you have as a woman is going to be taken away from you. And from my standpoint, when I watch that, I will think, well, what woman is really going to believe that? But I can tell you, as I campaign and as I knock on doors, there are women that are hearing this message over and over and over again, and they do ask me. They'll say, well, you're a woman, you're a Republican, and I'm hearing this. Is this true? So it's definitely a strategy that they have taken. It's a formula, and they use it over and over again, that if you vote for a Republican, all birth control pills will be taken away from you, or whatever the issue is, anything but the real substantive issues of taxes, the role of government, what's happening in education. And then the question is, where do we go from here? How do we, as Republicans, respond to this and pierce through just the formulaic attacks that the Democrats are doing?
So this is really those Saul Alinsky tactics that we've heard so much about and that have been perfected by so many, unfortunately, in politics. This, you know, straight out lying, but if you say it enough, people will tend to believe it, and at the same time demonizing your opponent instead of trying to just talk about differences on issues.
It's a message that they have the money, and in Virginia, the millions of dollars that are rolling in that are from out of state. In reality, Ken Cuccinelli and Terry McAuliffe have raised an equal amount of Virginia money, but the amount of money that is pouring in from out of the state and the messaging anywhere from gun control to abortion, that's pretty much what you can sum up is the message of the Democrat Party. And one of the other TV ads I saw, I was just appalled, but it was about gun control, and as they started it, they showed pictures of the murderer in the Virginia Tech massacre and the murderer from the massacre of the school in Connecticut, and equating that to Republicans and just appealing to those visceral emotions that really have nothing to do with the policy that limits our freedom. So from the standpoint of Republicans, we're going to have to figure out how to push back on these thug tactics.
You know, politics has always seen some bending of the truth, if you will, or trying to paint opponents in a different light. We've seen this forever, but I think you're making great points here of this is just extreme, even from 10, 15 years ago, where there are flat-out lies told, and you have the backing of a lot of the media. You have the backing of others that want you to win. And then, like you said, you knock on someone's door, and a woman who heard this believes this stuff and puts it against you.
Well, and from my standpoint here at the local level, it's something that can be pierced through because these are your neighbors. These are people that you see day to day, so they know you. But I did shop in the grocery store yesterday, and there was an older woman who lived in a very, an old neighborhood that ran into me, and she said, what is going on with the Republicans in Virginia? They want to take away every choice that a woman has. Now, this is a very solid Republican female that supports me, that I know, but that messaging is piercing through. And I think at some point, Americans and the citizens, they're really going to have to say, all right, enough is enough. I really need to look at this a little more deeply and just and look at the issue itself.
And perhaps Republicans need to take the gloves off and call them out on it every single time it happens, whether it's in an ad or on something said in a debate, and go at it, you know, like a Governor Palin would, like a Ted Cruz would, not like, say, a McCain or a Romney would.
In my opinion, that would be the response that I would have. I would simply turn it back on them. But we're going to have to, as a party, unite around this and push back on these tactics. But right now, it's working.
All right, Susan, sounds good. And happy Halloween to your kids and you.
That's great, and I will talk to you next week.
Susan Stimpson in Virginia. More Commonwealth Common Sense next week.